We have some new and surprising infos about the Tesla stock. It is rebounding exactly as we foretold over a week ago. And we got some super interesting info about Tesla's upcoming Cyberpunk Blade Runner pickup truck.
We also have some ultra cool updates on the next generation Tesla Roadster. Will it be able to fly? Can it hover over the street? Speaking of flying, we also have a lot of interesting news on flying cars. They are coming. I mean, it's really about time.
So stay tuned for these news and more on this week's episode of Electric Car and Other Stuff News. So please, everyone, act surprised now, act surprised, because the Tesla stock is indeed rebounding as we have foretold over a week ago. We talk about our views in this video here, detailing why we thought that the Tesla stock is being suppressed by FUD created by shorters. In this video, we also detail how big shorters like Jim Chanos are creating this anti-Tesla media narrative. Almost only negative news articles were released in the last 6 months on Tesla, making the stock decline from $380 in December 2018 to insane lows of just below $180 last week. But no surprise, the stock is rebounding. Well, we don't want to brag or anything like... But this had all the trademarks of A-grade stock market manipulation, like textbook manipulation, where big hedge funds or big investment banks like Morgan Stanley make insane profits with shorts on the way down, and then opening very large long positions at the very bottom they themselves helped to create.
And now, don't be surprised if the news media suddenly turns friendly or more positive on Tesla. This is not coincidence, but carefully crafted, because the hedge funds and investment banks have now opened longs. Now we will finally get a more realistic view on Tesla for the next few months, at least until they go short again, and call their buddies at CNBC to spill out invented shit stories on Tesla again. Anyway, soon or later, Tesla will be so big that this kind of manipulation won't work anymore. We remain bullish on Tesla because we see it as the Bitcoin of the auto industry. Highly disruptive with extreme upside potential. In 2030, the stock will trade a lot higher than today.
Now in other news, Elon Musk gives us some new updates about the Tesla Cyberpunk Blade Runner pickup truck. This here is the only rendering we have until now, which was teased at the Model Y presentation. Many have speculated, what the hell is this? Is this the front, the back? Many renderings had been released, some good, some not so good, some cool, some weird. But Elon has now confirmed that this teaser image here shows indeed the front and not the back. Boah, now if this is the front, that is some real Blade Runner shit going on right there. I mean, if that is the case, then Elon actually did not exaggerate. The front indeed does have some resemblance to Deckard's police car from our all-time favorite movie Blade Runner. We are absolutely excited.
But equally as impressive is the Rivian destroying price, starting at 49K. That's right, that's a whopping 20K less than competitor Rivian R1T's starting price of $69K. Bam! And the range for the more expensive trim versions will be from 400 miles up to 500 miles. 500! That's pretty insane, we'd say, but Rivian's specs are also around that ballpark, with about 400 miles of range and a strong performance. And we have to say that we also like the look of the Rivian pickup truck. So it will be highly interesting to see Tesla and Rivian battling each other in an epic showdown of gigantic proportions. Then Elon also teased some new stuff about the Tesla Roadster. He said that this car, which will probably come out by late 2020, has the mission to obliterate and destroy gasoline supercars in any metric, like absolute annihilation of gasoline supercars like Bugatti, Lamborghini, and Ferrari. Not only will it accelerate much faster at 2.1 seconds to 100, but with a range of 1,000 kilometers, be also superior with range and at a much lower price. Elon said that he wants the new Roadster to destroy the halo effect of gasoline sports cars, where people wrongly think that gasoline supercars can't be matched by EVs.
Now Elon wants to finally destroy that misconception, and we think that's super important and awesome. And he stated that the acceleration with the additional SpaceX thruster package could reach an insane 3G. That's freaking insane. That's like space rocket kind of acceleration there. Ciao Bugatti and Lamborghini, it was nice knowing you. However, don't expect many roadsters to be built. Elon said that they plan to build around 10,000 roadsters per year, which makes sense because the car is more expensive and will start at around $200,000 in the base version. But for people who now cry out and say, Tesla are cars for rich people, please take a look at the prices of the Bugatti Veyron and Porsche 918 Spyder. I mean, that's actually an insane bargain if you think of it like this.
Then the Gigafactory 3 is progressing nicely, just as planned. Exterior work is almost finished, and now apparently interior work has already begun. The factory is expected to go online by quarter 4 this year, with the first Model 3s already starting to be produced there by the end of 2019. And you can already order Chinese-produced Model 3s in China, which of course is quite a lot cheaper than the US imported version. And this had led the website for ordering instantly crashing down due to the insanely high amount of Chinese people wanting to order the car. So much for the fast narrative of demand for Model 3 is low in China. Stupid fasters.
And now to some news which will finally make the world of Blade Runner come true, right in time for November 2019. So on the one hand, we actually have the Blade Runner Cyberpunk pickup truck from Tesla, and on the other hand, we'll actually soon have flying cars. There are actually a lot of companies working hard right now and pushing to be the first ones in this exciting and emerging market of personal flying passenger drones or flying cars, or call them whatever you will. So we, for example, have the Chinese company Ehang with their quite exciting passenger drone Ehang 184. They already conducted some flight tests as early as 2017, as far as we know, where some impressive videos exist showcasing its flying capabilities. It is fully electric and can fly fully autonomously. However, the downside of this drone is that it only has a fly time of around 23 minutes and it still is quite loud currently. So they will need to improve the specifications a bit more to make it attractive for large-scale use in big cities. But of course, there are also some other companies working on personal flying drones, like for example the Hexa aircraft.
The specs are quite similar to the Ehang 184. It's also being powered by batteries that propel 18 electric motors and propellers. The flight time is a bit lower with 15 minutes, and we assume it's also quite loud. However, it has the cool feature of an automatically deployable parachute in case of emergency, and it can land on water. Let's see if these features can give it an edge over the Ehang 184. And then there's another promising startup from the city where we live. Yes, the Bavarians can not only use it and drink huge amounts of beer, but can also build flying cars. We were equally impressed when we found out. Believe us. So the company is called Lilium, and their personal flying drone, the Lilium Jet, is quite interesting. We actually find it's the currently most promising flying drone car thing that really has the potential for widespread use in cities. The specs are really amazing. First of all, it can fly for 1 hour at a speed of 300 kilometers per hour, giving it a far greater action radius than the Ehang and the Hexa aircraft.
Well, the engines are not propellers, but 36 specially designed air blades that are much more silent than the propellers of the Ehang 184 and the Hexa aircraft. Plus, it's designed to be also ultra safe with lots and lots of redundant backup systems. We think that until now, Lilium has the best product on the table. And this comes really close to enabling flying cars as we know them from sci-fi movies. The company plans to make the Lilium Jet available as soon as possible, and they are expanding quite rapidly. They are actually building 4 new factories in Bavaria, and their business model is they want to lease the jets as air taxis, which they say will not be more expensive than a normal taxi ride, but much faster. The current timeline foresees the first Lilium jets flying in large metropolitan areas around the whole globe by 2025. In some countries, of course, earlier, depending on regulations, in some countries later.
So what are your thoughts on Tesla's Blade Runner-style pickup truck? And what do you think of our interpretation of Tesla's futuristic pickup truck?
I've tried to draw it as good as I can, but I cannot draw better. I'm sorry, okay? And what do you think? Which is the most promising of all those flying personal drone car thingies?
And if you're new to this channel, we would be very happy if you would subscribe such that you don't miss any future updates on spaceflight, electric cars, and other technological fancy stuff.
Hyperloop, boring company tons, Neuralink, everything. Okay? Everything!
See you next time!
Ciao! We'll be right back.